Hey guys, welcome back to another video. In this video, I'm going to design the last part of the logos I promised to my subscribers. Again, I apologize that it's coming late. So this is the last one for Firecest Media Tech video. I'm going to keep this really simple. I'll just show you how to design. This is going to be a 3D logo on a white background. I get a lot of comments showing me how to create that white background, so I'm making this video with respect to that request. So without wasting much time, let's get started on it. First, I will create a big template, a YouTube thumbnail, so that I'll have more room to design. Then this brand, I want it to have like a fire, since the name starts with fire. I want it to have like a fire symbol. So this is more like your creativity, allowing your creativity to come in place. Next up, I'll add a shape. Tech-like shape. I'm just going to keep this simple. The main part of this video is the aspect of creating that plain background. I'm just going to write the brand name. Take it slow, where you go, I go too. And if you hit the bottom, I'm going down with you. Let's take it slow, who cares where we gotta be? You know you'll have a good time wherever you're with me. Let's take it. In logo designing, there is something called typography. I've not really talked about it. I'll do a separate video for that, but basically it means your main heading, like the brand name, should be on your main heading. It should be bolder than the tagline or any other supporting names, so that users will immediately see your brand name whenever your logo pops up. So the convention is to use a bold text, a large text for your brand name, then the tagline or any other supporting name should be smaller in size. So I just added some spacing to these taglines so that it aligns with the Firecest. Okay, I'm just going to apply some coloring to it. I want this to have a color similar to the fire. So I'll choose a gradient. And I'll select my colors from that symbol. Okay. I want this to become a shape. So I've explained why I'm doing this in my last video. Okay, so I'll go back to this column and choose the gradient. So I used the color picker and chose the colors from this fire icon. So I'm just trying to maintain a convention for my logo. Okay, this, because I want a white background, I need to use a darker color. And I just love this purple and black gradient. So I'll use that for this symbol as well. Okay. Now I can merge. Okay, this is the part where I'll create the white background. So do have to pay attention on this. Okay, so firstly, you go to this background section and click on the color tool. I'm going to use a gradient. So the gradient I want is from the diagonal like this. So for the first color, I'm going to use like a milky color. Okay, for this, it's going to be white. Okay, so I'm going to give this logo an illusion of a 3D slanty logo. So I'll apply the emboss to. Like I said, there is no right or wrong way to do this. You can simply use the same styles I used. Then I'll use a 3D shape and use the depth of tree. The depth color I will use gradient and select the same background. I'll show you why in a bit. So for the rotation, I can remember, but the x-axis is supposed to be, but you can play around with it until you achieve that perfect. Okay, I think I'm okay with this. Yeah, I'll change the light angle. Okay, Okay, lastly, I'll apply shadow to this. Reduce the blur, reduce, and set the offset to -4 for the X axis and 2 for the Y axis. Okay, so with this, I'm basically done with this logo. So in this logo design, you've learned how to create this background. Importantly, you've also learned how to apply 3D effects to your logo and give an illusion of a slanty logo. I hope you find this video useful. Thank you guys for watching. Lastly, I'll just save this logo. While saving, to get the optimal quality, export in ultra dimension. As you can see, this logo, I didn't use any external resources. So with this app, you can design. This app has a lot of tools that you can use for your designs, and you can also import external tools as well. So thank you guys for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.